Good morning, students. Today we will start new chapter, that is reproduction in animals. Remember, we have done reproduction in plants in the previous class. So you need to understand first what is meant by reproduction. Reproduction means the process of formation of young ones of their own kind. Okay, so what is the meaning of reproduction? Reproduction is, we can say, ये वो process है organisms में जिसके अंदर एक individual अपने जैसा दूसरा individual produce करता है, अपने जैसा, ठीक है, ऑफ देयर ओन काइंड. मीन्स इफ द ह्यूमन बींग्स आर देयर, सो दे विल गिव बर्थ टू द यंग वंस लाइक ऑफ देयर ओन काइंड. ठीक है, एंड व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन? रिप्रोडक्शन हेल्प्स इन मेंटेनेंस द नंबर ऑफ स्पीशीज. ठीक है, इट हेल्प्स इन द कॉन्टिन्यूटी ऑफ लाइफ. सपोज देयर इज वन ऑर्गेनिज्म and he don't reproduce further, so what will happen? After some time this organism will die, because ultimately everyone have to die. So after some time there will be no life on earth. So that's why, what is important? Reproduction is important. So reproduction in plants we have done in class 7. In this chapter we will study reproduction in animals. ठीक है, it is just like the process of, जैसे हमारी body में digestion चलता है, circulation है, respiration है, इसी तरह से एक ये सारे के सारे प्रोसेस हमारी लाइफ के लिए एसेंशियल हैं. सिमिलरली द रिप्रोडक्शन इज आल्सो एसेंशियल फॉर कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द स्पीशीज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, क्लियर? देन दिस इज द टेबल दैट दे हैव गिवन, द यंग वंस ऑफ द एनिमल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दे हैव गिवन ह्यूमन बींग्स, देयर यंग वन आर नोन एज द बेबी. Dogs, what we call them? We call them puppy. Then cat is there, we call the young ones of the cat kitten. Clear? So similarly you can fill this all. Now mode of reproduction. So first of all we have to define the reproduction, then we will discuss the mode of reproduction in general. Okay, so mode of reproduction is, there are two mode of the reproduction by which the animals they reproduce. First is the sexual reproduction, second is asexual reproduction. So sexual or asexual reproduction mein you should know the difference between sexual and asexual reproduction. Okay, now if we see, if we remember the reproduction of the plants of class 7th, we have studied there, the in the plants they have the main reproductive organ, that is the flower. This is the main reproductive organ. Okay, this flower take place in the important role, or it take part in the sexual reproduction. But we have studied about the plants also which show the asexual reproduction also. If you remember little bit, if we talk about the asexual reproduction, little bit about that, about the asexual reproduction, just to recall, we have studied about the spore formation. If you remember it, we have also studied about fragmentation. we have done the fragmentation. Yes. Then similarly, we have also studied about one more method, that is by the roots. We have by the stem, remember little bit, cutting. So these all are the asexual reproduction, but we are concerned here about the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction means the reproduction where the sex organs or the reproductive organs are involved. For example, in the plants, the flower was involved in sexual reproduction. So similarly here you will see sexual reproduction in animals. Here the male and female have the different reproductive part or the organs just like the plants. Okay, what is the function of these reproductive organs? They produce the gametes which fuse to form the zygote. The zygote then develop into the new individual. Clear? So it means that if we generally talk about the thing that sexual reproduction involves reproductive organs. Organs should be there. Okay. Then these organs produce the gametes. The gametes will be male and the female. ये मैंने आपको बताया था, इसे show करते हैं. They fuse. They form the zygote. And zygote develop into the new individual. Okay. So this is the general process of the sexual reproduction. So here first we will talk about what the reproductive organs. हम इनके बारे में देखेंगे reproductive organs. So see here, first of all, the definition of the sexual reproduction. It is the reproduction which involves the formation and fusion of gametes. That is the sexual reproduction. Now reproduction के लिए first thing I have told you, that is the reproductive parts. ठीक है, so we will study about the reproductive part in the male and the female, because we are studying about the reproduction in the humans. So humans, male and the female, we'll talk about the male reproductive organs. So in the humans, males, the main reproductive organ which is involved in the reproduction, this is the pair of testes. Okay, then two sperm ducts and the penis. Okay, what is the function of the testes? The testes produces the gametes. We call these gametes sperms. The testes produce millions of the sperms. Okay, this is the diagram. You can see here, this is the general structure of the sperm. Very simple structure bataya hua hai. The sperm contains the head, contains the middle piece, it contains the tail. Tail help them in to move. Middle piece, we previous chapter we have studied about the mitochondria. Mitochondria gives ATP. So this ATP is what? They give the energy. Head. What this head contain? Head contains the, again previous chapter ko link karte hain hum. It contains the nucleus. What nucleus contains? Nucleus contain the DNA, or we can say chromosomes. And chromosome contains what? DNA contains what? Genes. And genes contain what? They contains the characters. Okay. So understood this, that this head portion is, that's why it is important. It carries the nucleus. Nucleus carries the DNA which contains the genes, and gene contains the characters from the parents to the offsprings. Okay, so the three main parts of the human sperm are given here. It contains the head, middle piece and the tail. Clear? I have told you the function of each and every part. Then this, you can see the diagram of the male reproductive system. This is the diagram of the male reproductive system. This is, you can see here, testes, pair of testes. Okay, these are the ducts. These are the duct. Duct क्या करती हैं? Duct यहाँ से sperms को लेके जाती हैं. The sperm go like this. This is the pathway. ठीक है, and from here it enters into this, that is the structure, male reproductive external genitalia, and through here the sperm goes out. So this is the pathway of the sperm in the males. Clear? So there is one question. If you see, what is the purpose of the tail in the sperm? It help in the swim. Where? When the sperm reaches in the female reproductive part. Because here the sperm go like this. This is the pathway. And this is the point where sperm meets with the egg. So that's why this is the purpose of the tail in the sperm. Similarly, now you will draw this. This is your work. You will draw the structure of the sperm in the notebook. You will also draw the male reproductive system diagram. Now coming to the female reproductive system, this is the structure of the female reproductive system. You will draw that also. Now the male reproductive organ includes again pair of ovaries. So this is the ovary present here. These are the pair of ovary present in the female. Then the oviduct. This is the structure of oviduct. You can see these are the oviducts. What is the function of the oviduct? Oviduct is the place or site of fusion of egg with what? This structure, sperm. So that is the function of carrying the gametes and the both the gametes, eggs as well as the sperm. Clear?